Hey, I'm Chris. This is MMA for You. I'm going to be doing my predictions for Invicta FC 15, Cyborg versus Ibragimova, which happens on January 16th. But before I get into that, I'd like to plug my author's website at www.chrismoldon.com. I am an aspiring author who specializes in the fantasy genre, and you can check out on my website, you can check out the Writers Talk web series, blogs, which are updated weekly, free short stories and buy stories for sale. Also on January 1st, my first novel, The Mustard Prince of the Condiment Kingdom, is coming out for $8.95 on my website. So please welcome the new year with The Mustard Prince. Okay, on to the card. I like the card overall. I am most likely going to this card live. It's in Costa Mesa, which is actually very close to me. I went to the Invicta event that was in the Shrine where Cyborg pretty much destroyed Charmaine Tweet's nose. And that one also had a great co-main event of Alexa Grasso versus Mizuki Inoue. Some fights here look pretty good. Mizuki Inoue does fight Lacey Schuckman, so that should be fun. Cristiane Stanley, she's fun to watch. Amanda Bell versus Eddie Gomez, I think will be cool. Escobar versus Angela Hill should be fun. So to say, Escobar has like, she has okay fights. Like, that's the thing. Some fights kind of drag, and some fights of hers are pretty good. Raquel Palui, she's really good. She's fine. Colleen Schneider, I think that should be a good bout. I think Souza versus Bennett, a lot of DeAnna Bennett's fights tend to be grinders, especially as of late. I can kind of see that as being a grinder. And it's actually nice to see in the first bout of the night, we have Megan Anderson versus Amber Brock, two prospects at 100, women's 145 pounds. It's really hard to find prospects in that division, no less in their 20s. Relatively, Megan Anderson's 25, Leibrock's 27. Both pretty tall too, actually. So it's just nice seeing new blood in a division that is kind of known as something of a wasteland, to be honest with you. But you know what? Let's get started. So at 145 pounds for the Invicta FC featherweight title, Cristiane Cyborg Justino fights Daria Ibragimova. So Ibragimova, 9-1 record, 1 win by TKO, 7 wins by sub, 31 years old. Actually, the same height, they're both 5'8". Ibragimova is on a 7-fight win streak, training out of YK Promotion. One of the only other notable fighters from there is Mariana Moroz. I watched one fight of hers. It was from Oplot. Her stand-up looked real sloppy. Her offensive takedown ability was all right. It wasn't anything great. And her Brazilian jiu-jitsu is actually, it's not too bad. I mean, she had an armbar from the bottom up on her opponent. I'd say probably her grappling's her biggest strength. Okay, Justino, 14-1 record with 1 no contest, 12 wins by KO or TKO, 2 wins by decision, 30 years old. On a 4-fight win streak. From what I read, she trains out of Shoot the Box / The Arena. But if I'm not mistaken, she trains at other places too. She is a former Strikeforce Women's Featherweight Champion and a current Invicta FC Women's Featherweight Champion. One thing that's very obvious is that she's very strong. She does have a brawling type of kickboxing. It's getting more technical as of late, but she swarms opponents. Relatively heavy-handed too. Her offensive takedown ability is pretty good, especially from the clinch. She can ragdoll opponents quite easily, and she does have some pretty strong ground and pound. I think this goes without say that Cristiane Cyborg Justino should win this by KO or TKO, probably in the first round, maybe the second. And this kind of just goes to show that the level of opposition at 145 pounds. I mean, like, I was watching a video of Ibragimova. I mean, you can say, oh, well, Rousey was beating bantamweights in less than a minute. And Cyborg's beating featherweights in less than a minute. Therefore, they're both the same level of skill. I mean, if you actually watch her fights, I mean, just the majority of, like, women's featherweights just don't have, like, a refined wrestling, striking, or Brazilian Jiu-Jitsu game. I mean, quite honestly, there's, like, three or four fighters at 145. I believe it's Justino, Bud, Gomez, I guess you can put in there, and Marlos Kunin that actually have something of a more refined game. Everyone else looks really sloppy. Generally not trained with a good camp. I mean, at least with 135, generally speaking, I mean, with some exceptions, some of them look just really bad, like on a technical level. But, you know, there's nothing wrong with a Sarek man's wrestling, just guys boxing. Amanda Nunez is boxing. Misha Tate, she's really improved her boxing. Her wrestling's good, you know. Yeah, Ronda Rousey on a technical level, her striking's not that good, but her grappling's top-notch, you know. Holly Holm, her striking's top-notch, you know. I mean, you can see the skill. Kat Zingano, you know, her Muay Thai is good. Her wrestling and grappling is good, too. It's a bit more refined. When I was watching, like, some of the opponents of Justino's, I mean, it's just not refined, you know. And that goes the same with Daria Ibragimova here. I mean, it's just, there's nothing in her skill set that makes me think, like, oh, wow, she has great, great jiu-jitsu. No, it's all right. Her wrestling's good. No. Her stand-up. No. Nothing. You know? So, yeah. Cristiane Cyborg Justino by KO or TKO. Next fight after that. For the women. Invicta FC women's strawweight title. Livia Renata Souza fights DeAnna, the Argentine assassin Bennett. Okay. Souza, 8-0 undefeated record. 7 wins by sub. 1 win by decision. 24 years old. She's gonna actually, they're the same height at 5'4", which is really surprising because, Souza is actually pretty small for 115 and can probably cut to 105, whereas DeAnna Bennett has had trouble cutting down to 115. Souza is the Invicta FC women's strawweight champion, beating Kacha Kankampa. Name of her game is a Brazilian Jiu-Jitsu. She's really good. She's good off her back. She can set up triangles really well. Her offensive takedown ability is not too bad. Stand-up's decent. You know, it's not that great or anything like that. Like I said, she's kind of small for the weight class. DeAnna Bennett, 8-0, undefeated record. 2 wins by KO or TKO, 2 wins by sub. 31 years old. Training out of Pit Elevated. Bennett's actually a pretty good wrestler. She's got a good clinch. There are times in her fights, though, where she can just really grind her opponent. Her stand-up's actually not too bad, but sometimes she doesn't always let her hands go. This one's tough for me to call. I remember DeAnna Bennett was actually having some pretty big problems with Kacha Kankampa on the ground. However, I think Kacha Kankampa is really underrated as far as a grappler goes. Really tenacious, too. Souza, like I said, kind of small for the weight class. Bennett's a pretty good wrestler in her own right. I think might have the better stand-up. Should be the bigger fighter here. So it's hard for me to call because Souza definitely has the jiu-jitsu to get the tap. But I got to go DeAnna Bennett in here. She's one of those fighters that's going to be a problem for a lot of women's strawweights. She can grind if she really wants to. She's a pretty good wrestler, and striking's not too bad. And she's also just big for the weight class, too, to the point where she doesn't always make weight. So I'm going to go DeAnna Bennett to win this one by decision. I think she can grind out a victory. I think she can avoid the ground enough, bad positions on the ground, do well enough on the stand-up, clinch against the cage to get the win here. Nice round of that at women's bantamweight. 135 pounds, Raquel Lionheart-Palui. I think it's Palui. Fights Colleen Thoroughbred Schneider. Colleen Schneider, 9-6 record. 4 wins by KO or TKO, 2 wins by sub. She also has 4 losses by submission. 33 years old. She's a taller fighter at 5'9 on a 3-fight win streak, training out of CSW. Her wrestling's good. Her ground and pound's good too. Her stand-up's average. I actually watched one of her more previous fights. I think it's against Dana Reyes, I think, if I'm not mistaken. And she really just showed, like, her stand-up's not too bad. Like, she actually was hitting, was doing some good boxing in that fight, taking her down, her opponent down, ground and pounding and whatnot. She did lose positions on the ground a couple times. Palui, 5-4 record, 2 wins by KO, 3 wins by decision. She also has 4 losses by sub. She's a shorter fighter at 5'7, a 3-fight win streak, trains out of Drysdale Jiu-Jitsu, from last I read. Palui, she's tough. You know, her stand-up's solid. She has a particularly good knees. I remember she dropped, she fought Eddie and Gomez in her last fight, dropped her with a body strike. I rewatched that fight. I think it was a knee to the gut. I'm not too sure. And her grappling's greatly improving too. She's getting her own offensive takedowns on her opponents a lot of times, and her ground and pound solid as well. I am pretty high in Raquel Palui. If she ever goes to the UFC, I think she can get wins there. She's well-rounded. Schneider's not too bad. Like I said, stand-up's not too bad. Good wrestler, you know. Solid fighter in her own right. However, I just like more of what I've seen for Palui's game. I also like Palui's power in the stand-up. I think she can do well on the ground against Schneider. So I'm going to go with Raquel Palui to win this one. I'll go with KO or TKO. I think she might even be able to get a ground-and-pound finish. Knockdown, ground-and-pound, or something of that nature. So Raquel Palui, KO or TKO. So, women's atomweight at 105 pounds, Amber the Bully Brown fights Lisa Ellis. Lisa Ellis, 15-10 record, 11 wins by sub, 4 wins by decision. She also has 7 losses by submission, 33 years old, but the same height at 5'4". Ellis is on a 2-fight losing streak, most recently losing to Beck Rawlings, if I'm not mistaken. She's only won 1 of her last 6 fights. She is a good wrestler. Offensive takedown ability is pretty good. And her Brazilian Jiu-Jitsu is good. However, she does lose positions on the and grappling. I don't know if she gets overexcited or whatnot, but all of a sudden it's like she's on top and all of a sudden she's on the bottom. Her stand-up isn't that great, to be honest with you. It's decent at best. Amber Brown, 5-1 record, 1 win by TKO, 2 wins by sub, 27 years old on a 3-fight win streak, trains at a fit NHB with the likes of Ray Borg and Tim Means. Her stand-up's good. The name of her game that I've always liked is her clinch striking. She has really good knees from the clinch. Her offensive takedown ability is good. And her last fight, she fought Costigan. I predicted she'd win. And she just bullied her to the ground, mounted her, and ground and pounded her. There's a lot to like about Amber Brown, actually. I'm pretty high on her, actually. I think that if she wins this, she should get the next title shot at women's atomweight. I expect her to beat Lisa Ellis here. I think that she can get the – if she gets taken down, I can see her reverse position and get, like, ground and pound. On the feet, like I said, I like Amber Brown's knees from the clinch, especially. I think she's really solid there. And just her overall clinch striking is good. I think she can get inside, bully Lisa Ellis. And should I go for a finish? You know what? Yeah, why not? Amber Brown, TKO victory. Next fight is that women's strawweight. Jody Escobar moves up to fight Angela Overkill Hill. Okay, Angela Hill, 2-2 record, one win by TKO, one win by decision, 27 years old. She's going to be a taller fighter at 5'3 on a two-fight losing streak. I mean, it was to Tisha Torres and Rose Namajunas. I mean, it's like, come on. Like, I have no idea why the UFC gave her such tough opposition. I really don't. It was just one of those things. She's a pretty good prospect. I think eventually if she puts everything together, she can be like a top 10 to 15, possibly borderline top 10 strawweight. Name of her game is her Muay Thai, especially her knees off the clinch. Those are really strong. She's not that great off her back, though. Her boxing, too, you know, when she punches, I remember when she fought, like, Rose Namajunas, she's going for punches. They're kind of wild, too. Jodi Escobar, 5-1 record, one win by TKO, four wins by decision, 29 years old. She's made a much shorter fight, not much shorter fight, but the shorter fight at 5-1 on a two-fight win streak, training out of Jackson Winklejohn. She last fought in November of 2014. I want to say she fought Nigdali Hivarikamonic, if I'm not mistaken. I rewatched that fight, actually. One thing about Escobar, she has an in-and-out style of stand-up. She uses a lot of movement to move laterally, goes inside, gets out. Her overall kickboxing is good. She does throwing combination, in-and-out, like I said. Her grappling's decent. I mean, she did lose to got her back taken by Chambers. She has been taken down, you know. But she's not, like, absolutely defenseless on the ground either. You know, there's a bit of hype, I suppose, if you want to call it, for Angela Hill coming into Invicta FC, and for good reason. She's a character. She's a good fighter. She's super raw, you know? I mean, she's only had 4 pro MMA bouts, hasn't fought for very long. But, like, stylistically, I don't know how she beats Escobar here. I mean, I guess she might be able to bully her against a cage and just unload knees and stuff. But, like, from range, I gotta favor Escobar here. I think Escobar can just move around, you know, use lateral movement and, you know, get in, throw some strikes and get out and avoid Andrew Hill's clinch game. And also, like, Andrew Hill, her punching, like I said, it's a bit awkward. You know, maybe avoid her kicks, but, like, Angela Hill is also not, like, the most, she doesn't use, like, great movement or anything like that. Escobar uses a lot of movement. I can see Angela Hill being favored in this fight, but I gotta go Jodi Escobar. I think that she can utilize her movement, get in and out, and win a close decision victory. So Jodi Escobar by decision. The things that worry me is really the size difference. Jodi Escobar should be, I would actually say, significantly smaller than Angela Hill. Next fight after that, at women's strawweight, 115 pounds, Lacey the Lady Schuckman fights Mizuki Inoue. Schuckman, 11-8 record, 2 wins by KO or TKO, 6 wins by sub. She also has 3 losses by submission, 27 years old. She's actually the shorter fighter at 5'2". She's trading wins and losses. Interesting that this is at strawweight. Both of them are pretty small for the strawweight. Shuckman's actually fought at 105, if I'm not mistaken, against Watterson. Shuckman showed some really improved stand-up in her last fight. She beat up Jenny Lou Shriver in her last fight. Looked really good, too. Brazilian jiu-jitsu skills are good, and she can scramble pretty well, too. Mizuki Inoue, 9-4 record, 6 wins by sub, 3 wins by decision, 21 years old, taller fighter at 5'4". Name of her game, actually, it's not just her boxing's really good, her jiu-jitsu's actually really strong too. Her boxing's good, she uses combinations, she just does not have power in her striking. Her Brazilian jiu-jitsu's really good, she can pass to dominant positions. and whatnot. Even against Alexa Grasso, I believe she took her down and passed a mount at one point of her fight. Like I said, she's a bit small for 115, but so is Schuckman. With that said, I gotta go with Mizuki and Inoue to win this one. Heck, I'll go by submission too. I think Mizuki and Inoue can beat up Schuckman on the feet, get an opportunistic takedown, take the fight to the ground, and get the sub. So Mizuki and Inoue by submission. Next fight after that, at featherweight, 145 pounds, Amanda the Lady Killer Balor fights Edian India Gomez. Okay, Amanda Bell, 3-3 record, 2 wins by KO, TKO, 1 win by sub. She also has 2 losses by submission, 27 years old. She's made a taller fighter at 5'8". She is a potent finisher. Something of a brawler in the stand-up. I mean, it's real. Her stand-up's a bit sloppy. It's pretty heavy-handed, though. She has a really aggressive ground-and-pound style. I remember she fought, geez, I forgot her name, Maria somewhere or another. And just nonstop ground and pound. The problem with her, she just gets over aggressive. When she fought Faith Van Doon, I remember she was on top, unloading ground and pound, and then she pretty much ignored the triangle that was coming and got triangle choked. That's the thing with Amanda Bell. She is like hyper aggressive to a fault almost. Eddie and Gomez, 10-4 record, 1 win by TKO, 7 wins by sub. She also has 2 losses by submission, 35 years old. She's a shorter fighter at 5'6 on a 2-fight losing streak. Training out of ATT. Now, I was actually looking at her losses. I mean, you're talking like 1 loss is to Ronda Rousey, 1 was to Amanda Nunes, 1 was to Tanya Avenger, like late career resurgence Tanya Avenger, where she's like champion right now. And the other one was Raquel Paolilli. So, in their 2-fight losing streak, too, it's to like Paolilli and Avenger. You know, like, they aren't like bad losses, it's only to top fighters. Gomez has some strong Brazilian Jiu Jitsu skills herself. Her stand-up's good, and her offensive takedown, but he's actually pretty solid, too. I actually re-watched Gomez's fight against Paolilli, because I remember Paolilli, I pictured Paolilli to win, and the way I remember it was a more dominant win, and then I rewatched the fight, and I was like, oh, hey, Gomez actually reversed Paolilli. She got like a half-guard sweep to single, to takedown, did well in the third round, took her down, managed to ground and pound her and whatnot. So yeah, I forgot that she actually did pretty well there. With that said, I gotta go Edian Gomez just to be the more well-rounded fighter. I think if she wanted to, she can take the fight to the ground and get the sub. And the stand-up, she's gotta watch out for Amanda Bell's striking. It's sloppy, but man, she hits hard and she's really aggressive. Gomez's striking isn't bad though. Her boxing's actually quite, pretty solid, especially relative to her weight division. Nonetheless, like I said, I think Edian Gomez is more well-rounded. I'm going to go Edian Gomez to win this one by submission. Next fight after that, at flyweight, 125 pounds, Christine Knuckle Stanley fights Shannon Sinn. Shannon Sinn, 2-2 record, 1 win by sub, 1 win by decision. It's a taller fight at 5'7". I remember she fought Maureen Warden and showed some pretty good stand-up. Before that, she lost to KGB Lee. And KGB is like one of the top prospects, not just in women's flyweight, but in like women's MMA. So, it's no shame in losing to her. But Sinn, her stand-up's not too bad. Her grappling's decent as well. There isn't like a standout skill with Shannon Sinn, though, that I can really see. She's tough, too. That's the other thing. Christine Stanley, 4-1 record. All 4 wins by KO or TKO, and her 1 loss is by submission. She's certified at 5-5 on a 3-fight win streak. Trains out of Teen Hurricane Austin with the likes of Liz Carmouche. She is a potent finisher. She's never been past the second round. Her stand-up's good. She can be real unorthodox. Like I said, she's the one that did the jumping, spinning back kick victory in less than a minute. Heck, less than like 30 seconds and won. But she does actually have some good stand-up, relatively heavy-handed. Her ground and pound's solid as well. I am actually pretty high on Christine Stanley. I got her winning this one. Probably, like I said, Shannon's pretty tough. I mean, she took a beating from Andrea Lee and managed to make it to the judges' scorecards. So I'll go Christine Stanley to win this one by decision. And finally, at featherweight, 145 pounds, Megan Anderson fights Amber LeBrock. So Amber LeBrock, 1-0 undefeated MMA record, with that one win being a KO over Marina Shafir. She has a 1-0 amateur MMA record, with her one win being by submission. 27 years old, 5'11", pretty tall, and actually Megan Anderson's taller. I actually liked what I saw from LeBrock's stand-up in that fight. I thought she looked pretty solid there. Ground and pound was pretty good too. Megan Anderson, 4-2 record, 2 wins by sub, 2 wins by decision, 25 years old. She's 6 foot. So I rewatched actually her fight. She fought Cindy Dandois and lost. She got taken down repeatedly, and I think she got subbed, if I'm not mistaken. If not, she lost the decision. I forgot. I saw her fight before that, though. I liked her stand-up. She did use straight punches pretty well. And even against Cindy Dandois, when like it was standing, I thought Megan Anderson was better in the stand-up. But it was, there weren't many stand-up opportunities there. Her clinch striking's good. And her grappling, despite losing to Dandois, well, actually, has, like, if she can get the fight to the ground, is really good there. Anderson's ground game isn't that bad. I gotta go with Megan Anderson to win this one. Just it came off a little more well-rounded, a lot more experienced too. I'm very curious about this fight actually, because like I said, they're both women's featherweight prospects, and they actually both look pretty decent, especially relative to the weight class. They actually seem a bit farther ahead than some of their contemporaries in the weight class. So I'm going to go Megan Anderson to win this one by decision. Tough one for me to call, though, actually. Amber LeBrock, I mean, she made a big splash meeting, getting the KO over Marina Shafir. Looks like a pretty good prospect in her own right. But and Megan Anderson did lose to Cindy Dandois, but like I said, she's a pretty good fighter despite that loss. And Dandois, despite her flaws, is especially tough to deal with, especially on the ground. Okay, to recap, I have Cristiane Justino versus Daria Ibragimova, Justino by KO or TKO. DeAnna Bennett versus Livia Renata Souza, DeAnna Bennett by decision. Raquel Paolui versus Colleen Schneider, Raquel Paolui to win that one by KO or TKO, if I'm not mistaken. Amber Brown versus Lisa Ellis. I have Amber Brown by KO or TKO. Jody Escobel versus Angela Hill. I have Jody Escobel by decision. Mizuki Inoue versus Lacey Schuckman. I have Mizuki Inoue to win that one by submission. Amanda Bell versus Edian Gomez. I have Edian Gomez win that by submission. Cristiane Stanley versus Shannon Sinn. I have Cristiane Stanley by decision. And Megan Anderson versus Amber LeBrock, Megan Anderson by decision. So that's it for my prediction for Invicta FC 15, Cyborg versus Ibragimova. If you have any comments, just leave them below. Also, don't forget to buy my first novel, The Mustard Prince and the Convent Kingdom, on my website at www.chrismodon.com for $8.95 on January 1st. So that's it for MMA for you. Thank you guys very much.